lost call.
Have you got his phone number?
The following contest is scheduled for one fall, and it is for the World Heavyweight Championship. Introducing the challenger from Charlotte, North Carolina, weighing in at 234 pounds, Ric Flair.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, it has been a history-making night. At the beginning of the night, Triple H was awarded the World Championship. By General Manager Eric Bischoff, and we are about to see Ric Flair challenge the game for the world's title.
Somehow I don't like the way you say awarded that title. He deserves it. Triple H deserves to be the champion.
Well, Ric Flair is certainly the underdog going in, but could it be number 17 for the Nature Boy? Brock Lesnar is no longer considered the undisputed champion, as he only competes on SmackDown. So Raw deserved its own world's champion. There's no doubt about that. It's hard to argue that the game was not deserving, but you should win it in the game, in the ring, not in a presentation.
Doesn't look like he's going to be a fighting champion.
Charles Robinson stepping in between, and a very confident look on the face of the new world champion, the game.
Yeah, when you say that about Flair, the dirtiest player in the game, Jonathan, just go ahead and say, he don't mind cheating to win, right?
Yeah, no, he doesn't. Nice takedown by Flair.
Uh-oh,
already now working on getting in the head by Triple H.
Now maybe Flair's getting a little overconfident. Yes.
I wouldn't say that Flair's overconfident. I think he's playing mind games. And again, who knows how he was awarded the title, and I'm not taking anything on that drop to hold. And Flair floats over into the front face lock on the game, and sets out, and counters into the hammerlock.
I don't know if this is smart of Triple H to try to out-wrestle Flair.
Flair has been in the ring with so many great... Jackie Briscoe's the Harley Race.
Just beat him up! Just beat him up!
The Dusty Rose, what a shot that was! Shot, and the game walked right into that one.
Oh, wait. Get your composure.
Nice big target there for Flair to aim at.
He's still there.
Shots.
He's all right. Don't blow your cool, Triple H. That's exactly what Flair wants you to do.
Daniel still has that battle scar on his head from them getting hit with that chair at SummerSlam by Shawn Michaels. In a match that Shawn Michaels won.
Oh, look out!
Tie, hip lock. And Shawn, I know you're watching live in San Antonio. Can't wait to see you back and continue that rehab, and you know the way. There are the wrist lock. Farrell can beat you in a lot of ways, King. He'll also talk to you as the match goes on. Get right inside your head, physically and mentally, quite frankly.
I know, it's nothing worse than somebody beating you up and talking to you at the same time. Come on, Triple H! I just think Triple H is a deserving champion. Is there anybody back in the locker room here on Raw that deserves to be the world champion more than Triple H?
Well, I'm sure it's an arguable point. I can't argue the validity of the athleticism of the game. Both men are starting out somewhat conservatively here. Neither want to make a mistake, because at this level, with this world-class competition, it only takes one mistake, and one fatal mistake, and you lose.
Oh, there you go.
Bring on hand by the game, a glancing blow. Flair comes back with a chop of his own, and then arm wringer now, and another chop. Laying those chops in, and this time the game connects with that big right hand, knocking Flair down to the canvas.
Good shot there. That rocked Flair. Get up, you dirty Flair.
I know that for many years I've talked to the game on occasion. He has had a lot of respect for Flair over the years, and Flair's just unbelievable run in our business. 16 times, Flair's a champion, and Flair's fighting back. And could this be the night again that Flair reaches the world championship? And where's that title again? Heart spine buster by the game. The power and the strength of the 6'4", 260-pound world champion.
It's true, JR. Flair don't have many enemies in this business. He's outlived them all. Let's face it, though. It would be an ego crusher for Triple H to lose to Flair. He's 53 years old. If he goes in there and beats Triple H tonight, oh my gosh, that would shatter the game.
That's what I alluded to earlier. Flair beat Chris Jericho, he was the first undisputed champion at SummerSlam in the figure four. And the game is not going to forget that.
No, I know Flair's capable of rising to the occasion, but right now he's lowered himself.
Flair upside down. The velocity of that Irish whip turned Flair inside out, upside down to the outside. And now the Nature Boy has got to regroup, but he's been there before. That's the thing about Flair. Never count him out. He's seen it all. He's done it all. He's beaten them all. But can he beat the world's champion tonight?